So we kind of ran out of time on the Beautiful Boy movie. So let's do that now before we get to the DVD of the week.
So, The Most Beautiful Boy in the World, which is a documentary about Björn Andresen, who was a Swedish teenager who in 1971 was cast into the world spotlight when he had a starring role in Lucino Visconti's film of Death in Venice. And he was famously declared by Lucino Visconti to be the most beautiful boy in the world. And the documentary is about his life and how his life was changed by suddenly being cast into this, you know, worldwide spotlight as the most beautiful boy in the world, but also about the whole of the rest of his life, which is very strange, sometimes very disturbing, but also very intriguing life story. So the documentary, for example, investigates the disappearance of his mother when he was a child, and it also has his own harrowing, heartbreaking memories of his own parenting. And the documentary builds up a portrait of a life which is completely at odds with this idea of, you know, serene beauty, which was portrayed by the public image of him in Death in Venice. We learn that he was signed to a contract that for 3 years they effectively owned his image. He went to Japan, in which he recorded pop songs and was used for commercials. And one of the things that the documentary talked about is how this very young man suddenly found himself a product, a commodity to be sold and, you know, photographed and used, but nothing to do with his own life and completely at odds with his own life. But also what's really fascinating is that it doesn't just do the, oh, you know, he was a child, he was a star, that was terrible. It follows, you know, the rest of the stuff that happened. He carried on acting. I mean, for example, in Midsommar, Simon, you saw Midsommar, right?
I did indeed.
Yeah, okay,
yes.
So you remember the bit at the beginning of,
I can't say I was thrilled.
But you remember the bit at the beginning of Midsommar when the elderly couple go up onto the top of the mountain and they throw themselves down?
Yes.
He's the old guy. He's the guy who face plants at the beginning of Midsommar. And it's, you know, rather brilliantly. I mean, I watched the film. I had no idea that that's who it was. I kind of feel embarrassed that I didn't know, but I didn't, because I didn't know anything about him outside of Death in Venice. So the film's really interesting. At times it's very disturbing. At times it's very upsetting. At other times it's kind of intriguing. What you do see during it, I think, is somebody looking back over their extraordinary life and coming to terms with, wrestling with and coming to terms with some of the issues with, you know, how Death in Venice changed. I mean, at one point, as I said, it is his treatment around the time of Death in Venice is referred to by one person on screen as tantamount to child abuse, that he was this young person who was suddenly taken, all his freedom was taken away, and he was made into a star. But it is much more than that, because his own life is much more than that, and much more complex and much more rich and intriguing. Anyway, I thought it was really, really terrific. You can find it in cinemas or online at Dogwoof On Demand and also some other platforms, and it's really well worth checking out. It's fascinating.